डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नॉट इज द टर्न ऑफ टीचिंग द थर्ड पोएम ऑन इज ब्लाइंडनेस। एट फर्स्ट वी शैल कम टू नो द पोएट्स नेम ऑफ दिस पोएम। आई थिंक सम ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स मस्ट नो द नेम ऑफ द पोएट हु हैज कंपोज दिस पोएम ऑन इज ब्लाइंडनेस। The title of the third poem is On His Blindness. It has been composed by John Milton. At first, I would like to tell you something about the poet's life. Poet John Milton was born in 1608 in England, and he died in 1674. It means he lived a life span of only 64 or 65 years. He is considered a very talented poet and an eminent English scholar of England as well as of the whole world. He acquired his education from Cambridge University, that is situated in England. In Cambridge, John Milton remained for 7 years. He completed his BA from there in 1629 and his MA in 1632. He married thrice in his life. His first wife's name was Mary Powell. The name of his second wife was Catherine Woodcock. And the name of his third wife was Elizabeth Mansion. This was his bad luck that he became totally blind in the year 1652. At the age of 44, he was very sad because now he was unable to write poems due to his blindness. He expresses his grief in this poem, whose title is On His Blindness. This poem may be called his autobiographical poem. He has written many other poems and long poems such as Areopagitica, Samson Agonistes, Paradise Lost, Paradise Regained, etc. And Paradise Lost is a great epic that has gained eminent popularity all over the world. Now we shall study his sonnet On His Blindness. Sonnet is a poem that contains 14 lines. On His Blindness is also a popular sonnet of John Milton. So now I think that you will be sitting with your textbooks and you will start perusal of this poem with me. Now start reading and understanding the hidden meaning of the poem. Now I start reading. Please see the first stanza of the poem. In the first stanza, the poet writes, "When I consider how my light is spent, or half my days in this dark world and white, and that one talent which is dead to hide, lost with me useless, though my soul more bent." The poet says that he is astonished, dumbfounded, how he became blind at his premature age of only 44 years. He says that his eyesight has gone. He says that he thinks कि व्हाट वाज द रीजन हाउ इज लाइट हिज आई साइट द लाइट ऑफ हिज आईज हैज गॉन एंड ड्यू टू हिज ब्लाइंडनेस द होल ऑफ द वर्ल्ड हैज बिकम फुल ऑफ डार्कनेस टू हिम द वर्ल्ड इज ए वाइट प्लेस एंड देर इज ओनली डार्कनेस टू हिम नाउ ही इज अनएबल टू सी एनीथिंग बट द टैलेंट ऑफ हिज राइटिंग पोएम्स इज विद हिम इट इज नॉट लॉस्ट द पावर ऑफ हिज आईज हैज लॉस्ट बट हिज टैलेंट हैज नॉट बीन लॉस्ट ही वॉन्टेड टू राइट मैनी मोर beautiful and inspiring poems but now a difficulty has been created he feels great difficulty and thinks how shall he be able to write his poem easily this talent of his writing poems will die only with his death And so it is now useless for him. His talent is useless for him because he has become blind. Although his eagerness of writing poems has increased very much. Now we shall read the further lines. The poet writes, "To serve there with my maker." And present my true account, lest he returning chide. To serve there with my maker and present my true account, lest he returning chide. The poet says that this is the responsibility of every human being that he should discharge or perform his duties well that the God has handed over to him. John Milton was a poet and his duty was to write good poems. But he is unable now due to his blindness. He says that he thought that he would serve God by writing poems, but now he is unable. So when he will depart from this world to the other world, to heaven, to what response will he give, what account will he present to his maker, the Almighty God? He may chide him, God may scold John Milton for not discharging his duties well. But his patience consoles him. This has been indicated in the further lines, so we start reading the further lines. The poet writes, "Doth God exact day labor, light denied, I fondly ask." The poet says that he foolishly asks, "Does God need a light denied person or from a blind man?" To do work. In the further lines, he also replies in his own will. He writes, but patience to prevent that murmur soon replies. The poet says that his patience consoles him. His patience replies, God does not need either man's work. Are his own gifts. Through his patience, poet John Milton tells everybody that God does not need either man's work because God is Almighty. God gives everything to the whole world. He does not need everything from any creature or any human being. But what is the real duty of human beings? This fact John Milton tells in the further lines. He says, who best bear his mild yoke, they serve him best. The poet is of the view. According to the poet, the persons who bear the sufferings given by God pleasantly, without complaining to God about their miseries or sufferings, this is the best service that everyone can do to God. In the last lines, John Milton tells us about the greatness of God. He writes, his state is kingly, thousands at his bidding speed, and post over land and ocean without rest. John Milton says that the state of God is kingly. God is the king of kings. Thousands angels are always ready to discharge his orders, to obey his orders without rest. They are ready to discharge his duties over land routes and sea routes all the time. And in the last line, the poet says, they also bear who only stand and wait. This line means that the persons, those who are satisfied with their lot, are the true worshippers of God. This is the best service from all human beings, that they should be contented with their lot, with their fate. What has God given to him, they should accept it with gladness, happily. This poem also, in the last, I would like to say that this poem also expresses the poet John Milton's deep faith in God. He also renders that we, all of us, have such a deep faith in God. And now I would like to tell you that the meaning of this poem I should teach in Hindi in the next video. So please wait for the next video.